It was on this day that we carried out a very successful attack on Karachi during the war in 1971. As you would all know, Pakistan attacked us on the evening of 3rd of December, and the very next day the Indian Navy was able to carry out a very successful missile attack on the ships outside the Karachi harbour, wherein we were able to sink one of their destroyers, Khyber, one minesweeper, Mahfiz, and also one merchant vessel which was carrying goods that could have helped them in their war waging abilities. So it's a very important day, Red Letter Day for us. So we carried out this attack on the 4th of December, and this was followed by another attack on the 8th of December, which was named Op Python, in which we carried out a very successful attack and sank one of the tankers, the oil tankers, which is required to fuel the ships at sea. We also carried out an attack on the same day which ensured that the Karachi oil storage was aflame. Right, as also highlighted by the Naval Chief yesterday, the Navy plans to have 3 aircraft carriers, and this plan is enshrined in the long-term integrated perspective plan which has been approved by the MOD. This primarily envisages us to have 3 aircraft carriers by around 27 to 2030, and for that, as you are well aware, we have already 1 aircraft carrier, which is Vikramaditya, with us. The second is under construction at the Cochin Shipyard Limited. And the third, plans are afoot to start the development process, because this aircraft carrier is planned to have to be slightly more different from the other two. It is slightly more larger than the existing aircraft carriers. Facing, the aim is to have 2 operational carrier battle groups at all points of time, and therefore for that we need to have 3 aircraft carriers, so that at any given point of time 2 aircraft carriers along with the other warships are always available to us. We operate from space because Navy has got its own communication satellite. We operate in the cyber domain. We operate in the air, on the surface and underwater. And as of now, we have got 117 ships. We have 15 submarines. That makes a force level of 132 platforms. In addition, we also have more than 225 aircraft that are available with us today. Maritime reconnaissance aircraft. We have carrier-based fighter aircraft, we have got helicopters which operate from the deck of the ships, and therefore it's a mix of a large number of ships based helicopters, as well as aircraft carrier based fighter planes and fixed wing maritime reconnaissance aircraft. As I think most of you are aware and our countrymen are aware, the Navy has had a ship permanently deployed in the Gulf of Aden since 2008, and till to date I'm happy to share with our countrymen that more than 4,000 ships, both Indian and foreign flagged, have been successfully escorted by the Indian Navy during the last 7 to 8 years. And we have also ensured that a large number of piracy attempts which were carried out by the pirates in that particular area have been thwarted by the active efforts of our Indian Navy. And therefore, this is a prime example as to how Navy ensures that our trade flows safely in this very important area that we are talking about. Went all the way to Manila, Philippines. Therefore, you can imagine that the concept of Blue Water Navy, which we are talking of now, is actually been with the Navy for quite some time. And when we look at back 40 years, 30, 35 years almost, we can say that the ships had the capability to go far off seas and operate in the areas that we are talking today. Coming to the first question now, we are operating with a large number of foreign countries, friendly foreign countries. As of date, we have bilateral exercises with 14 navies. We have trilateral exercises. We also participate in certain exercises where we are specially invited, like the ADDM and the RIMPAC. And therefore, Indian Navy, because of its professional standing that it has in the world over now, a large number of our friendly foreign countries do want to interact with us on a regular basis. And we are always extending a hand forward to ensure that our bridges of friendship are built across the seas.
Sir, I'll take you.
Subset of the maritime security, as you are well aware, and therefore I would also like to emphasize that coastal security cannot be entrusted to a single agency, because there are a large number of stakeholders, starting from a number of central agencies as well as the states that themselves which are involved, where we have the coastlines. A rough count would indicate between 12 to 15 stakeholders as far as coastal security is concerned, and we are coordinating the efforts of all these stakeholders to ensure that we have an unbreakable coastal security barrier around the country. Specifically, as you brought out, we have started the AIS chain, which has been Director General of Lighthouse and Lightships, We have the LRIT, which is being coordinated, that is long range in identification and tracking, which is being coordinated by the DG Shipping. We also have a coastal radar network which has been set up at the Indian Coast Guard, and this entire information is coming through a unified domain and coming to IMAC Center through the National Command, Control and Communication and Intelligence Network setup that we have built up, and therefore the entire information is available at a place very close to Delhi in Gurgaon, and we have an active picture now which coordinates and tracks all the ships. Right from the beginning, the Navy has been focused on ensuring that we become a builder's navy and not a buyer's navy, and therefore I'd like to inform our countrymen that our first indigenous warship came up in 1961, a small vessel called INS Ajay, which was built at GRSE Kolkata, and from then on we have remained focused on ensuring that we are able to produce the warships in India. I'm happy to say that today we are one of the few countries in the world where we build warships from the size of a fast patrol craft to an aircraft carrier, destroyers, frigates, submarines, etc. in India, and we also design them. Specifics, if you want, then today there are 32 ships that are under construction in various Indian shipyards, both private and public. In addition, we also have acceptance of necessity, as I bought out, for 62 more vessels, which include submarines, and most of them, in fact all of them, are going to be constructed within the Indian shipyards. The Navy has been totally focused on Indianization, and just to give you some other facts, in the last 4 years, more than 80% of the acceptance of necessity which has been given by the Defence Acquisition Council has been to Indian vendors. More than 70% by value of the contracts that have been concluded in the last 4 years have been with Indian vendors, and since we can talk of the budget, more than 2/3 of the Navy's capital budget in the last 4 years has gone towards payments to indigenous, to Indian vendors. The range of the BrahMos is more than 250 kilometers, and it is basically an anti-ship weapon. That is, you are able to prosecute an enemy ship with this particular missile. You fire it from a ship. And today, all the modern destroyers that we have commissioned, that is the Kolkata class, has got the BrahMos missiles. The new ships that are going to come up are also going to have, under construction ships, are going to have BrahMos missiles. Even in the older ships, like the Shivalik class and the Delhi class, where we had the other missiles, are going to be replaced by the BrahMos missiles in the future.